incredible. Simply incredible.
Hello, Professor.
Hello, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, sir. Good day, good day. How are you?
Well, my family's health and well-being are being threatened by some unscrupulous government agents, and my own hard-won freedom is under duress. But these problems aside, I suppose I'm fair.
Yes, the problems of civilizing nomads. Tell me, sir, are you from Norse stock?
Not as far as I know. I was raised in an orphanage. My father was Scottish.
Unfortunate. You'd make an interesting case for my theory of natural population characteristics.
Really?
Well, yes. A white man, obviously, but with a savage spirit. Trust me, sir, I mean savage in the best possible sense. Natural nobility, but also simple. Pure. I've been looking at some blood samples through my microscope, and you know what?
No.
Well, of course you don't. It's a remarkable breakthrough. I've been looking at the blood of both natives and white men of corresponding height, weight, and age, and you know what?
Again, no.
They're exactly the same. It's remarkable. It completely refutes my last book. But I'll tell you what, sir. This sabbatical in the field may have been somewhat forced upon me by circumstance, but my scholarship has benefited enormously. Would you like to partake of a syringe of cocaine? I've quite enough for two.
Not right this minute, no.
Well, it's a remarkable drug. It entirely restores the ego. It takes one back to a primal state. It helps my thinking enormously. Oh, Nastas, come on. Come in, sir. Would you like to take off your slippers? Or skin a rabbit? I know we cannot see the stars, but still my heart is pure, and we meet as equals. These savages must be spoken to simply in metaphors.
No, sir. I grew up on a reservation and attended school.
Oh, lovely.
But I can show you what you want to see. I know where the group of bandits you seek are hiding, both of you. Vanderlyn has attracted a following of young men on the reservation. They are turning to bad things.
The savage heart cannot be conventionally civilized. I was right all along.
Where's Dutch Vanderlyn based?
In the hills, in Cochinay. Let's go. I know a way there that is not guarded.
Marvelous. It's simply marvelous.
Mister? Time to do our bit for humanity, Mr. Marston.
Come. Let's hurry. Stay close. Come on.
So, I understand we have a mutual interest in Mr. Vanderlyn?
You gonna kill him too?
Kill him? Good God, no. What is it with you people out here? No, yeah. Vanderlyn fascinates me. A white man living among natives. A civilized mind turned savage. It's reverse integration or regressive acculturation that... I don't know. I haven't found a name I like yet.
He was never that civilized.
Ah, but of course. Edgar Ross mentioned your unique history with the man. Although I was away with the fairies at the time, I must admit. Surfing great waves of euphoria. But anyway, yes. Some kind of Robin Hood, Oedipus, communist, tale of naivete and betrayal, if I remember correctly.
We ran in a gang together, Professor. I wouldn't try to read too much into it.
It's my job to read too much into everything, dear boy. Look, Mr. Marston, buffalo. Oh, what a noble beast.
I see him.
The white man will soon be the end of them.
What on earth are you talking about, Nastas?
Too much hunting, sir.
Your whole society is based around hunting.
But we hunt to eat, not for sport. Soon, there will be no buffalo left.
Who teaches you this nonsense? Extinction is a myth refuted by Darwin. Species don't die, they evolve. Hunting in time will make the buffalo stronger. These trees are quite foreboding, Nastas. Are you sure this is the right way?
Yes, sir.
It's rather dark.
Ain't you never seen trees before? I thought you were a brave cultural explorer.
It's this way, mister.
Go Good Lord, no. I rarely leave my room. I explore with the mind, Mr. Marston.
Enjoy it while you still can. Soon you will have cut down all of these trees.
Me? Or are you making a sweeping statement about the white man in general?
There is no respect for the land anymore.
Some anger. Talk me through this primal emotion, where it's coming from.
Don't worry about it, Professor. Here and climb the rest of the way.
Remarkable. I'm afraid I don't really have much of a head for heights. More of a head for highs. Well, anyway, I'm sure Nastas will help you. I must be on my way. I've got work to do.
Thanks for the help.
Goodbye, gentlemen. Enjoy yourselves.
Come on! I see a spot where we can climb up. See if you can find another route, Mr. Marston. I will have a look around. There's a cave over here. Might go through or up the mountain. Good. This should save us some time. This way! I'm hurt pretty bad.
I don't think you should go any further.
I'll be fine. But you go ahead. I don't want to slow you down.
You sure you're all right?
Just need to take it slow. Go on. I'll catch up or see you on the way down. Don't worry about me. Go look for Vanderlyn. Good luck.
This is dirty.
Mr. Marston? Mr. Marston! Mr. Marston! Here you go, Mr. Marston.
Put that stuff away.
You banged your head. Nastus and I carried you down. Mm. Well, Nastus heard the shots and he hurried up to rescue you and he carried you down. I improvised an escape plan. I'm more of a planner than a man of action.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Friends of mine are with Vanderlyn.
We must try to reason with them, sir. Vanderlyn's gang contains several natives. We must meet with them and try to save them from disaster.
My people have already endured many disasters. Before, this was all our land.
And now we have brought you civilization. Well, sure, it hasn't been easy, but it hasn't been easy for anyone, Nastas. Why, I knew a man in Yale whose father once shot 18 natives in one afternoon out in Wyoming. Oh, the man was quite traumatized. He took to lying with choir boys.
For a wise man, you are a very stupid man, mister.
Gentlemen, I'm gonna leave you to figure out right from wrong.
You are simple-minded, sir. Thus, I do not blame you for not understanding reason. Then again...